This is the day that the Lord has made. Those familiar words of praise leap from the pages of Scripture with all of the excitement and splendor of a new dawn. For throughout history, whenever man has paused to contemplate the marvels of the physical universe, he has more often than not been filled with a deep sense of wonder and awe. And in the process, come face to face with the reality of his Creator. The Apostle Paul wrote that since the creation of the world, God's invisible attributes, his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly seen, being understood from the things he has made. To anyone who will stop and look, all creation is a testimony, a continuing revelation of God's existence and character. And when it is viewed in the light of biblical truth, the imagery conveyed takes on unforgettable dimensions. Join us now in a spirit of both worship and praise as we consider not only the beauty and wonder of creation, but also the power, majesty, and promises of the God who made it all. For this indeed is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hands. Day after day, they pour forth speech. Night after night, they display knowledge. There is no speech or language where their voice is not heard. Their voice goes out unto all the earth, their words to the ends of the earth. Lift your eyes and look to the heavens. Who created all these? He who brings out the starry host one by one. Because of his great power and mighty strength, not one of them is missing. of stars and calls them each by name. Great is our Lord, and mighty in power. His understanding has no limit. It is He, God, who sits enthroned above the circle of the earth. He stretches out the heavens like a canopy and spreads them out like a tent to live in. Surely the nations are like a drop in a bucket. They are regarded as dust on the scales. He weighs the islands as though they were fine dust. For He views the ends of the earth and sees everything under the heavens. Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more important than food, and the body more important than clothes? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store food away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they? Why do you worry about clothes? See how the lilies of the field grow. They do not labor or spin. Yet I tell you that not even Solomon in all his splendor was dressed like one of these. If that is how God clothes the grass of the field, which is here today and tomorrow is thrown into the fire, will He not much more clothe you,